फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय क्लास। टुडे टुडे यू प्रोसीजर ऑन हॉट वाटर बैग एप्लीकेशन। सो फर्स्ट यू मस्ट नो व्हाई हॉट वाटर एप्लीकेशन इज गिवन। सो द पर्पस, हॉट वाटर विल कॉज वैसोडायलेशन, दैट मींस इंक्रीज ब्लड सप्लाई, सो दैट बाय इट रिलीव्स द पेन। एंड नेक्स्ट इज टू रिलीव द मसल स्पैसम। ओके, इफ देयर इज एनी स्टिफनेस और इंक्रीज टोन ऑफ द मसल्स, टू रिलीव द मसल स्पैसम हॉट वाटर बैग एप्लीकेशन इज गिवन। एंड नेक्स्ट इज to promote suppuration. Suppuration means
healing.
When we give hot water, it will increase the WBC, neutrophil and phagocytosis function, which hot water bag application is needed. And then in case there is a retention of urine, okay, so if the patient is having difficulty in passing urine and he is having retention, to relieve the retention of urine, hot water application is given. And also if there is any abdominal pain or abdominal spasms like renal colic, so in these conditions we apply hot water bottle to relieve the pain because it causes vasodilation. And next is the contraindication. So in all, what all conditions we should not apply the hot water bag, so that is if the patient is having any open wound or injury. Okay, so when there is open wound or injury, there can be bleeding, and when you give hot water application, it will cause vasodilation and thereby can increase the bleeding. And patients who are unconscious or any paralyzed patient or weak and debilitated patients, for these patient hot water application is contraindicated, because so these patient there can be injury and burns, so you don't advise for paralysis or any patient, unconscious patient who cannot feel the
heat.
And it is also not given in case of any inflammation or infection. Okay, if the patient is having any open infection, inflammation, because again it will cause vasodilation and there can be more of congestion. In order to prevent that, we don't give hot water bag in case there is an inflammation or infection. And in case of malignancy, malignancy is cancer, so in cancer patient it can again increase the multiplication of cells because there will be vasodilation and increased blood supply. So cancer area we don't apply the hot water bag. Okay, in case of edema and any diseases of the lymphatic system, so in these conditions we don't give hot water bag application, because in edema the skin will be very fragile and it can easily breakable and it can cause burns. And then it is not advised in headache, because in headache it will cause location of the nerves and thereby they don't advise hot water bag application in headache. Okay, so now coming to the procedure. So before doing the procedure, you have to doctor's prescription, like why the patient need hot water application, on which area the hot water should be applied. So all those doctor's order we have to see when giving the procedure to the correct patient. Do a preliminary assessment. So before doing a procedure, we have to wash hands thoroughly
and prepare the articles.
We need a hot water bag, so this is to apply the hot water, and to cover the hot water bag we need a cloth, so a towel or a cloth to cover the hot water bag, and a dust cloth, so this is to wipe the hot water bag if there is any water spilled out. Okay, I need a kidney tray to collect the waste, and we need a mug with a hot water, and also if available lotion thermometer can be used. Okay, so lotion thermometer is to check the temperature of the hot water. So the temperature for hot water bag application is 49 to 65 degrees Celsius. In Fahrenheit it is 120 to 150
degree Fahrenheit
should be there. Or if there is no lotion thermometer, you must see that the water is boiling heat, that is it is very hot and the steam is coming out. Okay, and whenever you are pouring the hot water, keep the hot water bottle in a flat surface, and you have to open the nozzle like this and then take the hot water and pour it in the hot water bag. Steam should be coming, so you have to see that it is very hot, and in temperature it is 49 to 65 degree Celsius. Okay, and always hot water should not be poured full, it has to be only 3/4. Okay, so if you pour fully, it can cause rupture of the bag, and also heat will not be insulated properly, so you have to only fill 3/4 of the bag. And while closing the bag, you should keep it in the flat surface and see the water is coming on the nozzle. Okay, so on the opening you must see the hot water
and close it with the water in the mouth of the bag. This will prevent air entering and cooling the water.
After closing the excess water, pour it kidney tray, and also you have to check for the closure of the lid, whether it is closed tightly by reversing the hot water bottle. Okay, and then if there is any excess water outside, you can clean it thoroughly so that it will not cause burns or scalds on the patient. And then you have to cover it in a hot water bottle bag, or you can use a towel if available. Okay, so you have to cover it nicely
and make sure the rubber portion of the bottle is not touching the patient's body.
So talk with the patient that you are going to do the procedure, and then you have to keep it on the area where there is pain. Okay, so like that, on the abdomen or on the legs or on the hand, wherever the patient is feeling pain, in those areas you can keep the hot water bag bottle. And also make sure the hot water bottle should be kept on the patient only for 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, so if you keep the hot water bottle for a long time, same place, it can cause scalding or burn injury. So to prevent that, keep it only for 10 to 15 minutes. And after care of the procedure, so you have to ask the patient whether he is comfortable, whether the pain is relieved. Okay, so do not leave the hot water tray near the patient's bedside, because it can cause injury and burns.
Take the tray back to the utility room and empty the water in the sink and dry the hot water bottle upside down and replace all the articles.
Please like, share, subscribe, and click the notification button for regular update of my videos. Thank you.